Imagine looking up at the night sky and knowing that just above Earth, a giant science laboratory is floating through space. That is Orbital Reef, a groundbreaking project set to become the first commercial space station, offering a new era of opportunity in low Earth orbit. Scheduled to begin operation by the end of this decade, this space station will be a multi-use hub facilitating space tourism, research, and business ventures. With a capacity to house up to 10 people and 830 cubic meters of usable space, Orbital Reef promises to revolutionize our relationship with space. As the International Space Station nears retirement in 2030, Orbital Reef will pave the way for a future where space is more accessible and versatile than ever before. Could this innovative structure be the key to unlocking the next chapter in humanity's exploration of space? In 1998, the International Space Station, or ISS, marked a turning point in space exploration. Orbiting approximately 400 kilometers above Earth, it has served as a hub for scientific research and international cooperation for over two decades. This colossal structure became an essential platform for studying long-term space habitation and the effects of microgravity on human biology. With contributions from multiple countries, the ISS has housed countless experiments, advancing science in ways impossible on Earth. From medical research to material science, the ISS played a pivotal role in expanding human knowledge and building a foundation for future space endeavors. But as time marches on, the ISS is set to retire by 2030. As it nears the end of its operational life, focus is shifting toward the next chapter of space infrastructure. Orbital Reef, an ambitious project, is poised to become the new face of space exploration. Designed as a modular and expandable station, Orbital Reef is more than just a research facility. It'll also be a commercial hub, offering opportunities for space tourism and business activities. With plans for a fully operational station by the second half of this decade, Orbital Reef aims to redefine human access to space. What sets Orbital Reef apart is its vision for a multi-use space station, often referred to as a business park in orbit. This new station will cater not only to astronauts and researchers, but to private companies and tourists as well. Its adaptable structure will allow for continued growth as demand increases, opening doors to a wide range of activities in space. Unlike the ISS, which was primarily focused on scientific research, Orbital Reef will expand the scope of possibilities, offering an accessible and dynamic environment for innovation. But as Orbital Reef prepares to take center stage, one crucial question remains. What groundbreaking innovations will define Orbital Reef and set it apart from the space stations that came before it? At its core, Orbital Reef is a modular station that will consist of several different types of components, each designed to serve specific functions while maintaining adaptability. The primary construction pieces are the life habitats, core modules, node modules, and research modules, which together will create the internal framework of the station. These modules are designed with versatility in mind, ensuring that future expansions can be easily integrated into the station structure. The modular nature of Orbital Reef allows the station to accept docking from almost any spacecraft in operation today, including spacecraft like the SpaceX Dragon 2, the Boeing Starliner, and the Dream Chaser. This flexibility is a key aspect of the design, ensuring that the station can accommodate a variety of needs and users. Whether the goal is to conduct cutting-edge scientific research, facilitate industrial production in microgravity, or provide tourists with an unforgettable experience in space, the infrastructure of Orbital Reef will be able to support it. The design of Orbital Reef places a strong emphasis on creating a human-centered architecture that can accommodate both long-term habitation and short-term visits. For example, the life habitats, one of the key elements of the station, are inflatable structures that expand to provide ample living space for astronauts and crew members. These habitats measure approximately 8x8 meters and consist of two floors, equipped with everything a crew of six would need to live and work in space. Within these habitats, you'll find science labs, robotics workstations, sleeping quarters, hygiene facilities, a galley for food preparation, and even exercise equipment. In addition, the station's Astro Garden plant growth system will allow for sustainable food production in space, a critical feature for long-term missions. In terms of pressurized volume, the life habitat will provide about 300 cubic meters of space, roughly one-third of the total volume of the ISS. Despite being smaller in total volume, the design of Orbital Reef's interiors focuses on maximizing the efficiency and comfort of living and working space. A central focus of the station's design is the creation of a streamlined and organized aesthetic, which is in stark contrast to the cluttered, cramped quarters that have often characterized past space stations. Particular attention is being given to the development of a social hub within the station, complete with a central table designed specifically for microgravity living. This attention to detail ensures that Orbital Reef will not only be a place for groundbreaking research, but also a place where astronauts can thrive. In addition to the life habitats, the station will also include node modules that act as connectors between various parts of the station. These node modules will enable Orbital Reef to expand as needed by adding additional living and working spaces, as well as vehicle docking ports. The core modules will serve as the backbone of the station, providing the infrastructure needed to support the various activities that will take place aboard Orbital Reef. These core modules will house critical systems such as life support, power distribution, and communication systems. They'll also feature large diameter berths that allow for easy docking of spacecraft and other modules. One of the most exciting aspects of Orbital Reef's construction is its use of advanced automation and logistics systems. These systems are designed to minimize the complexity and cost of operating the station while maximizing its efficiency. Reusable space transportation systems will play a key role in ensuring that the station remains operational and well supplied. In addition, smart design features will enable Orbital Reef to automate many of the routine tasks that are typically performed by astronauts, allowing them to focus on more critical work. This approach to automation not only reduces operational costs, but also makes the station more accessible to a wider range of users. Power for Orbital Reef will be provided by a series of solar arrays mounted on trusses attached to the station's core modules. These solar panels are similar in design to the iROSA arrays recently installed on the ISS, offering a reliable and efficient source of energy for the station's operations. Heat generated by the station systems will be dissipated by large fin-like radiators attached to the station's exterior, ensuring that the station remains at a stable temperature during its time in orbit. The construction of Orbital Reef also involves the integration of various cutting-edge technologies designed to support human life in space. This includes advanced environmental control and life support systems that will recycle and reclaim air and water to minimize the number of resources that need to be resupplied from Earth. In addition, the station will be equipped with systems for removing harmful contaminants from the air and purifying water, ensuring that the station remains a safe and healthy environment for its inhabitants. Orbital Reef will also feature deployable structures that will support microgravity research and manufacturing activities. These deployable structures will provide additional space for experiments that require exposure to the vacuum of space or specific environmental conditions that cannot be replicated on Earth. In addition, specialized spacecraft designed for external operations will be used to conduct maintenance and repairs on the station's exterior, as well as to facilitate tourist excursions outside the station. Despite its ambitious design and advanced technology, the construction of Orbital Reef has faced several significant challenges. One of the primary hurdles has been the coordination of the various components of the station's design, which involves multiple teams working together to ensure that the system functions as a cohesive whole. This process has required extensive testing and validation of the station's systems to ensure that they meet safety and performance requirements. In particular, the station's life support systems have undergone rigorous testing to ensure that they can support human life in space for extended periods of time. This has included tests of water reclamation systems, air purification systems, and waste management systems, all of which are critical to the station's long-term viability. Nevertheless, the Orbital Reef team has continued to make progress, with several key milestones reached in recent months. As of the latest reports, the project is on track to begin operations by the second half of the decade, with the first modules expected to be launched and assembled in orbit by 2027. By creating a flexible, modular space station that can adapt to the needs of its users, Orbital Reef is setting the stage for a new era of human presence in space. If you enjoy this journey, please like, comment, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more exciting content.